And this criterion is called modified condition decision coverage, also called MCDC. This criterion is very important because it is often required for safety critical applications. For example, the FAA, the Federal Aviation Administration, requires for all the software that runs on commercial airplanes to be tested according to the modified condition decision coverage. So what is the key idea behind the MCDC criterion? It is to test only the important combinations of conditions instead of all of them, and limit the testing costs by excluding the other combinations. And the way in which it works is by extending branch and decision coverage with the requirement that each condition should affect the decision outcome independently. So let's see what this means with an example that will also show you how you can reduce the number of combinations in this way. I'm going to show you an example of how MCDC works using this predicate, which consists of three conditions, A, B, and C, which are all in AND. So the overall predicate is A and B and C. The first thing I'm going to do is to show you how many test cases we will need to satisfy the multiple condition coverage for this simple predicate, which means how many test cases we will need to test all the possible combinations of true and false values for these conditions. So I'm going to populate this table. And as you can see, at the end, we have 8 test cases. Each test case tests a different combination of values for A, B, and C. I'm also showing for each test case the outcome of the overall predicate. So for example, if we look at the first one, the first test case will be such that A is true, B is true, and C is true. And therefore, the overall outcome of the predicate is true. Now let's consider the first condition, A. As I said a minute ago, what we want to test are the important combination, which are the combinations in which a single condition independently affects the outcome of the overall predicate. So if we consider A and we look at this possible set of test cases, let's try to find two test cases such that the only difference between the two test cases is the value of A and the overall outcome of the predicate is different. If we look at the table, we can see that this is true for test cases 1 and 5. If we look at these two test cases, we can see that the overall value of the predicate in the two cases is true and false, and that the only difference between the value of the conditions is in the value of A. So these two test cases satisfy exactly what we wanted. There are two test cases in which the value of A independently decides the overall value of the predicate. What we do, therefore, is to add these first two test cases to our set of tests down here. Now let's focus on B, and let's try to find two test cases such that the value of B is the only value that changes between the two test cases, but the overall value of the predicate is different, the same thing that we did for A. And in this case, we can see that if we select test case number 1 and test case number 3, we have exactly that situation. B is true in the first case, false in the second one. A and C don't change, but the overall value of the predicate changes. And now you can notice something else, that even though we selected two test cases to test the two values, one we already had. So we only need three test cases overall to test A and B according to MCDC. Now let's look at our last condition, C. At this point, we know the game. So we just have to look for two test cases that satisfy our requirements. And in this case, 1 and 2 are suitable candidates. And once more, because we already have one, we just have to add 2 to our list. So as you can see from this example, we went from having 8 test cases needed to cover all the possible combinations of conditions to only 4 test cases to satisfy the MCDC criterion. So now let's see where MCDC stands in our subsumption hierarchy. This is what we had so far in the hierarchy, and this is where the MCDC criterion will stand. MCDC criterion is stronger than branch and condition coverage. Why? Because it requires every single condition to be true and false, and therefore it subsumes the condition coverage criterion. And it also requires every predicate to be true and false, and therefore it subsumes branch coverage. And in addition, it's got the additional requirements that the true and false values of the conditions have to also decide the overall value of the predicate. So it's stronger, which is more thorough than branch and condition coverage, and as usual, also stronger than branch coverage, statement coverage, and condition coverage.